brethren, I pray you sing a new song. Sing praise in the assembly of the righteous. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let the high praise of God be on the mouths of the saints and a two-edged sword in their hands to execute vengeance on the demonic nations and punishments on those peoples, to bind their kings with chains. Dishonor have all his saints. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Sing to him a new song.
Second Ezra, chapter 6, verses 8 through 9. And he said unto me, from Abraham unto Isaac, when Jacob and Esau were born of him, Jacob's hand held first the heel of Esau. For Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. Shalom, Zion, and giving all praises to the great I am. The greatest power that the Most High can ever bestow upon us is the fact that he has chosen us above all nations. That being said, what on this dusty earth do we have to fear? You see, fear is only a state of mind. Many of our people fear for the unexpected. They fear for what they cannot see. But the Most High has already assured us that not one hair on our heads will be harmed or touched. You can bank on that. But let me share with you what will happen if we only turn back to the Most High and keep his laws, commandments, and statutes. Jasher chapter 13 and verse 4. And now, therefore, if thou wilt hearken to my voice and keep my commandments, my statutes, and my laws, then will I cause thine enemies to fall before thee, and I will multiply thy seed like the stars of heaven, and I will send my blessings upon all the works of thy hands, and thou shalt lack nothing. Now, we've experienced this once during King David, but it's going to happen again. But we need to turn back to the Most High. We need to keep his ways. But see, y'all don't want this. Many of you would rather just keep your oppressors' holidays. You love them holidays so damn much that you would break your neck trying to keep them. And what's so sad about it is that you will try to outdo your oppressors in keeping their holidays. Now that's crazy. Now let me just show you the frightening amount of money that our people spend just about every year on shopping. Just shopping alone. It says black shoppers spent $1.4 trillion. Y'all hear that? Didn't say million. Black shoppers spent $1.4 trillion just in 2019. That's crazy, y'all. According to the most recent buying power statistics, that is crazy. I mean, like, we shouldn't really be surprised, but the numbers are frightening, brothers and sisters. This is crazy how much money our people will spend. And the sad part about it, we only make up a small percentage in the U.S. So how is it possible for us to spend this much money? This goes to show you where our priorities are, how we can spend all this money on everything else, but we won't come together and buy land. We won't come together and invest in ourselves, but we'll give it all away to everybody else except our own people. Where do you think all this money is going to go once it leaves their hands? It's going to go into the white communities. It's going to go into the white economy. It's going to go into the Asian economy. It's going to go in to the Chinese economy. You name it. But it's not going to come back to us. We are the biggest consumers. And you can back this article up. You can find this in 7 different sources. You cannot make this stuff up. This is what's going on with our people. And no matter what you try to tell them, it's the same thing every year. And the spending increases more and more. Total destruction. Destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Black people, you should really go ahead and just give yourselves a pat on the back, because you just entered into the infamous Hall of Shame. Look at here. Our people still singing that old song. That old song of Christianity and religion. The old song of marching and giving all your money to the black churches and to your enemies. That's what you do best, and you would stone people if they tell you otherwise. The black men love their long, straight-haired white women, and the black women love to straighten their hair to look like the white women. But if you straighten your hair is not working, and these brothers are still going after the white women, then it must not be the straight hair, sisters. So now, with that being said, you can go back to wearing your natural beauty. The only way we're going to receive power is to come from under our oppressors. Mentally, physically, and spiritually, brothers and sisters, we got to come from under our oppressors. And you already know what that looks like. I've talked about it many times. You all know what that looks like, so don't even ask me how do we do that, because you all know. Come on, brothers and sisters. Y'all not that naive. Or maybe many of you are. Hell, what do I know? I know one thing. You all better wake the hell up. Now, have y'all been paying attention to the next moves that the elites been planning? Did y'all know that they're getting ready to mass flood America with Afghanistanian refugees? That's right. Afghan refugees. You've probably been hearing the rumors. You have many over here that are secretly over here in the U.S. already. And by the year 2025, they plan to have hundreds of thousands of Afghan refugees here. And let me tell you something, brothers and sisters. If y'all think that this is just coincidence, this stuff was planned by the elites. The whole purpose, you gotta watch this documentary called The Three World Wars. And it was talking about Albert Pike's prediction. And the Third World War would involve the Islam destroying the Christian West. So wouldn't it make sense to flood America with Afghan refugees to bring on the Islam religion to confuse and to clutter everything else, to destroy the Christian West? I mean, all of this is prophesied, brothers and sisters, so it should not come by no surprise. But all of this is going to work out to the benefit of the Most High's people. You may not be able to put your hand on it. You may not be able to predict exactly what's going to happen. But we're getting ready to see a huge influx of Afghanistanian refugees. You watch what I tell you. It's getting ready to get crazy. Another reason why they're doing this, brothers and sisters, not only to use Islam as a tool to destroy the Christian West, but they're also doing it because they know that there is a rising amongst the Most High's chosen people. And when I tell you that they truly know, I don't got to go into all the specifics. You all know the deal. But we know that this plan is going to backfire. It's going to backfire so hard that we're going to see the true light. Everything seems confusing right now, and rightly so. But I tell you, the Most High will reveal his plan. You will see it come to action. Like I said earlier, the only thing we have to do, brothers and sisters, is turn back to the Most High and keep these laws and commandments, our rightly heritage, with all our heart, mind, and soul. If you're not willing to do that, then the Most High has no other choice but to destroy you and cut you off forever. And maybe that's what some of you want. If that's the case, then why are you here? Why are you trying to act like everything is done away with? Just go ahead about your business and do your dirt. Break all the laws you want and live your life. Strive to be rich and filthy and all kinds of things. Live your life. But don't waste your time with the Most High. That's the worst thing you can do. And look, we got to come out of this mindset of the fear of what our enemies can do to us. We're constantly fearing everything. I've never seen a people in my life that just sits there and fear. Every negative thing that our people can think of to prevent them from moving ahead, they want to bring it up. Oh, you can't start no business because the white man is going to bring us down. We can't buy land is because we got to pay taxes and it's going to be taken from us anyway. I mean, y'all black folks complain about everything. And y'all exhibit the most fear out of any race on the face of the earth. Did not the Most High said that we can do all things through him? So don't be afraid. Stop worrying about what your enemies are going to do to you. Stop worrying about what people think of you. Stop projecting your fears on other brothers and sisters. You know, it's funny because I did a rhetorical questionnaire video last week, and just the amount of negative comments I've seen, it's like, oh no, we can't do it because, and we know that our people are not together, and there's a reason for that. We're not together because of self-hatred. We've turned away from the Most High, his commandments and his laws. We've totally turned against one another. We don't even have the love for our own brothers. We don't even love ourselves. You know, and that's where it starts. But the Most High gave us power. It's like he's sitting back and allowing you to see your mistakes and allowing you to wallow in your fears, so that you can get up off your behind and stop feeling sorry for yourself. If the Most High put in your spirit to start your little business or to buy some land or whatever, then you don't need to fear, brothers and sisters. You just need to start planning and start trusting in the Most High. Now, it's not going to come exactly when you want it, but if the Most High gave it to you, you need to go forward with it. You don't need to sit on it. The parable of the talent is a prime example. You got skills, use it. You have skill sets and things you've been blessed with naturally, use it. But don't sit on it because you're scared of what the white man's going to do to you. So if you want to sit there and continue to sing the same old song, you go right ahead, my brothers and sisters. You do just that. And guess what? You're going to find yourselves cut off from the Most High forever. It will be as though you were never born. I hope this is a wake-up call for you, brothers and sisters. I really do. Open your eyes and see what's going on. And like I said earlier, be sure to check out that documentary called The Three World Wars. I believe it's called The Three World Wars, but it's the prediction of Albert Pike. I've had it in my other videos. I'm not going to post it because I get tired of reposting stuff that I've already shown you already. So you guys are going to have to do the work and do some footwork and get out, and you're going to have to search this stuff for yourselves. But if you want to see it, just go check out the video I did. It's titled The Prophecy of Zechariah 12:3 is Coming to Pass. And I have the documentary listed on that video. So go check it out. With that being said, I say Shabbat Shalom and stay strong.
Gotta thank Yahweh for being the chosen seed of Israel. Here's the patience of the saints. Here are they to keep the commandments of the Yah and the faith of Mashiach. Oh, yeah. I gotta thank Yahweh for being the chosen seed of Israel. Here's the patience of the saints. Here are they to keep the commandments of the Lord and the faith of the Mashiach. Oh, hey, whoa. I'm here to encourage you, brothers and sisters, trying to paint to you a better picture. Everything I say, I back it up with the scriptures to get you out the matrix. It's been over 400 years of life. To open up your eyes, 'cause there's so many reasons we in captivity. You gotta flee from the heathens. There is hope in our future, even though they trying to do a scene. But we live to fight another day. Vengeance is to Yah. We'll be praying for Yahweh's day. Gotta thank Yahweh for being the chosen seed of Israel. Israel. Here's the patience of the saints. Whoa. Here are they to keep the commandments of the Yah. Commandments of the Yah. And the faith of Mashiach. Oh, 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 yeah, yeah. I gotta thank Yahweh for being the chosen seed of Israel. Israel. Here's the patience of the saints. Here are they to keep the commandments of the Yah. And the faith of the Mashiach. Do-be-do-be-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do